I was already like shaking because I knew. And then he just told me that they found three tumors in my head, and that it looks like I have a condition called neurofibromatosis type 2, which I had never heard of before.
We got used to her as a perfect little girl, perfect young woman, you know, very cheerful. And I think nobody could have imagined that there is something to this magnitude is happening to her.
He had asked around, like, what, basically, like, this is what happened. Does anyone have any information on where we can go? What's the best people to see? And a lot of people recommended Dr. Schwartz and Dr. Friedman.
We thought that she would be a good candidate for tumor removal and placement of an auditory brainstem implant, which can help her, God forbid she loses the hearing in her other ear.
Just given the nature of our program, we never want patients to wait to feel connected. And I remember that first phone call to the patient's father where he explained about the diagnosis and hearing the fear in his voice and the anxiety and the uncertainty. You know, I knew that we needed to connect with them as soon as possible.
We all agreed that that was like our first like breath of fresh air is when we met you guys and like talked to you guys. I mean, everyone's just so knowledgeable and confident, and just to know that I was in the right hands, like it was just easier to know that.
So most patients with NF2 will lose their hearing nerves on both sides and will end up totally deaf. In this situation, we have to do whatever we possibly can to restore hearing. So in the group of patients with NF2, we've now been placing what's called ABIs, which is auditory brainstem implants. But what we're trying to do with an ABI is give some auditory information to somebody who otherwise would be in profound silence.
I think the Acoustic Neuroma program at UC San Diego Health is unique. As far as I know, we're the only program who has a program coordinator slash patient navigator, and that's Chris Sywick, who is so well known to many, many patients around the world. We have obviously a collaborative team between Dr. Schwartz and I. And we also have collaborations with neuroradiology, neurooncology, neuroanesthesia, audiology, all of otolaryngology actually, and neurosurgery. And we have a state-of-the-art hospital that recently opened, and it's just a fabulous place to care for patients.
Why this is so important to me is I was a patient of Dr. Friedman and Dr. Schwartz back in 2010. I know what it was like to go through the surgery. I understand the fears, I understand the stress, and I want for them so much to have the best possible outcome and to feel that kind of support, and more importantly, to know that there is so much life after this diagnosis.
The doctors and everybody was just so, so kind and supportive of us and of her.
For them, it goes outside of the boundaries of the OR suite and to the actual quality of life measures for their patients. Being behind two surgeons that are so committed to both the patients and their families, but also to outcomes, is so important in today's medical environment.
I've gotten so much better at walking around. I feel like I've gotten used to how my brain is seeing. It's less stressful, it's less like alarming, like you were saying. It's just kind of like my new normal. And like I said, I can understand people better because I'm getting used to the way I hear and I balance, I can strut like I'm on a runway. And I would like them to know that I have recovered amazingly. And I feel like that would not have been the case if they hadn't done my surgery. I feel like they did a fantastic job, and the fact that they've checked on me, they FaceTimed me, it's just really nice to know that they're still thinking about me and not just like a patient. It's like a little relationship. So it's nice.